Hey church, welcome to our devotions today. Hope you are good wherever you are tuning in from. Great that you can join me today. My name is Emily Foster and I'm one of the pastors here at church. And today we are looking at Proverbs 24. I'm not sure if you've been tracking from the beginning, but if not, I just want to take a moment to say how good is Proverbs as a book. It's just brilliant. King Solomon, great guy, loads of God-given wisdom. In this book, you can find just absolute gold, so many nuggets of truth, wisdom, principles. Basically, if you want to know how to do life well, then you need to read this book. So I recommend, if you've not read any of the other Proverbs, go back, listen to some of the other devotions. But today, we are looking at Proverbs 24. So where we find ourselves in this proverb is that King Solomon is basically giving us 30 wise sayings, okay? So this chapter here in Proverbs 24 is the last 10 of King Solomon's wise sayings. And they're all good, but I'm just going to focus on just one saying, saying number 21. And we find this in verses 3 and 4 of this chapter. Again, there's so many incredible wise sayings. And in fact, it gets to 30 and then basically just says, and there's loads more wise sayings. So then he just carries on. So I recommend go away, read it in your own time. We're going to look at starting at verse 3 and verse 4. And this is saying 20. Sorry, I think I said 21. But this is saying 20, okay? And it says this. It says, by wisdom a house is built, and through understanding it is established. Through knowledge its rooms are filled with rare and beautiful treasures. I love it. Well, right now as a church, we are in a series looking at family and relationships. So I've just got a few thoughts that I thought from these verses that are going to help add to everything that we've already been learning. So this is one saying here, just one wise saying from King Solomon. By wisdom a house is built, through understanding it's established, through knowledge its rooms are filled with rare and beautiful treasures. And from this one saying, I reckon there's three keys here that he talks about in terms of how we can build our house to find these rare and beautiful treasures. Now, I'm not talking about as having some big building projects in our houses, some extensions or some grand design, some interior design, finding the best new sparkly light fitting that we can have. No, I'm talking about us building our homes, the homes that we live in, the people that we do life with, our family and our friendships. I want to look at some things here that I think can help us build families and relationships of strength, of just incredible richness and great treasure. So, key number one that he says here, key number one is wisdom is the first key. Wisdom. Proverbs 24, verse 3. By wisdom, a house is built. In order to build the homes we want, the homes, the kind of families that we want, the environment, the atmosphere that we want, then he says here that we need wisdom. I reckon we've always all experienced a time when we've said things that we wish we could take back. You know the times where something leaves your mouth and you're like, no, come back. Or we've reacted to certain situations, and then basically what's happened is that things blow up, get out of control, and you end up having to fix everything. And I think most of these scenarios, if we look at it, actually what we really needed was just a little bit of wisdom. Knowing what to say and what not to say. Knowing when to say it and when not to say things. All of that requires wisdom. I know that I've learned over the years that if I want to have an important conversation and I want results from the conversation, then wisdom has taught me, do not have these conversations when your spouse is watching football or when your kids are watching their favorite TV show. It doesn't go well. There's no fruit from it. Things don't happen. So wisdom has taught me there is certain times when and when not to have conversations. I've often caught my kids saying certain things to one another and I'm like, no, you know that one sentence or that one word is just going to cause some explosion. And as you hear your kids kind of saying that one sentence, that one word, you just wait for everything to go crazy and you're like, no, why did you say that? We have to choose our words wisely. We need wisdom to know what to say. What are the things that are going to encourage, that are going to build up, that are going to bring peace, that are going to be strategic, that are going to help move our families, our relationships forward. And there's some words that we can say that are going to do that. And then there are definitely words, phrases, sayings, areas that are just not going to help us build great homes. We need wisdom, and we particularly need it when it comes to our words, what we say. Also, I think it's super important when we're trying to build our homes is that not just our words, but also our actions. I think wisdom's taught me certain things, and you know, there's certain actions, certain things that we do in our homes, in our relationships, that just really irritate each other, that don't help our situations. Wisdom would say that if it really irritates your spouse, if maybe they spill something and they don't wipe it up, or if someone in your family finishes something, eats it all, and then just puts an empty packet back in the cupboard. These kind of actions can cause friction, can cause tension. You can fill in the blanks for your homes, things that go on with you and your families. But we have to learn that certain actions are going to help and certain actions are going to hinder. I think it's pretty amazing when we think about it, how much wisdom really does play a part in us building incredible homes. Homes that we can have great atmospheres, homes that we can have fun, homes that function well. We require wisdom. It's also amazing that wisdom is great for when we hit brick walls in relationships. Certain family situations, I think many of us will come at no times where we've just hit a brick wall and thinking, this isn't working, we're not getting through, or this, you know, we're hitting this brick wall, we keep hitting the same kind of roadblocks. And in verse, let me read you what it says in verse 14 of this proverb. It says, also know that wisdom is like honey for you. If you find it, there is a future hope for you, and your hope will not be cut off. Wisdom can bring you hope that there is a future and that there is a way forward in your relationship. So I want to encourage you, maybe if you've hit in roadblock after roadblock, you're hitting brick walls, I want to encourage you, ask for wisdom. The good news is that the Bible says that we can ask for wisdom. James 1 verse 5 says, if any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to you. So wisdom is available to every one of us, and we need wisdom, guys, to build great families, great relationships that are of strength and that can have longevity and that can have just be rich. So I encourage you, key number one is wisdom. The second key that he talks about here in verse 3 is understanding. It says, and through understanding, it is established. In other words, our houses are established through understanding. I think as we work to understand each other more, we can establish great foundations that our relationships can be built on. Having understanding of one another, it builds strength in our relationships, it builds stability, and it builds security. We need to spend time understanding each other, getting their point of view, understanding their beliefs, understanding their feelings, their emotions, kind of where they're coming from. And without understanding, we end up second guessing, we assume, we can make judgment without really knowing the truth. And I think that's often why some of our relationships remain really shallow and or can have lots of tension within them. It's simply because we've not taken the time to understand one another. I think when it comes to understanding, it definitely takes time, takes patience, and it takes some good listening skills. So many of us are so quick to jump in and talk. I'm probably guilty of that. We want to kind of jump in with conclusions. We want to go into fix-it mode. We sometimes maybe accusations. But really, I think if we're going to build good, strong, healthy relationships, then we need to develop the habit of seeking first to understand. Stopping before we speak, just taking a moment to pause, allowing the other person to listen, give them opportunity to express their feelings, their where they're coming from, their opinion, what there is that they want to say. I think as we understand each other more, as we take time to understand each other more, then we're going to establish relationships and an atmosphere of encouragement, of honesty, of honor, and of openness. And I reckon that's all the kind of keys in relationships that we want to create, the atmospheres in our homes we want to create. So I'd encourage you, let's commit to being people who understand each other, that take the time to understand each other. Seek first to understand. So key number one is wisdom. Key number two is understanding. And key number three is knowledge. Verse 4 says, through knowledge, its rooms are filled with rare and beautiful treasures. I think it's as we build our knowledge of one another, this is where we see one another's worth, where our relationships really can begin to shine. The true treasures are revealed. Now, I love it when you discover new things about a person. Maybe it's something that they like, or some kind of experience, something that happened to them, that, you know, telling stories, you're like, wow, I never knew that happened. I never knew you'd been there. Never knew you'd experience this. Recently, one of me and my best mates, who I've probably known for over 20 years, we discovered that we have a dislike to a certain color. This color is purple. Sorry if you're a purple lover. I personally am not a purple lover. And I've discovered just the other day that neither is my friend. And we had a moment where first we were like, no way, just excited that we kind of both shared that same thing, but also had this revelation of, hang on a minute, we've known each other for 20 years. How have we never discovered this particular thing? The trouble is that our lives are so fast-paced. We go from one thing to the next, and often we fail to be present in the moment. And I think in terms of gaining knowledge about one another, it's about being present in the moment. Parents, how often are we there trying to, you know, play a game with our kids, but also on our phones, and we're not present in the moment? Or we're having that conversation with someone, and really we're kind of listening, but we've also got our eye over here at the next thing that we've got to do, or the next conversation that we have, and we miss the opportunity to just gain knowledge, to learn about one another. And I think it's really important that when we're building our family, building our homes, that we take time to be present in the moment, so that we can gain all the knowledge that we can about each other. Imagine how much richer our relationships would be if we committed to doing this, to finding out what it is we like, what it is we don't like, what it is we're hoping for the future, maybe some of our fears, maybe some of the things that we're believing, dreaming for, that actually if we really got to know each other a lot more. And I think it's when we gain knowledge of each other, we can actually love each other better. We learn how best to serve one another. We learn how best to encourage one another, to build them up. I'm sure we all love getting gifts, but we love the gifts more when it's from someone that's taken the time to know what we really like, that we know that we're going to appreciate it, enjoy it, get to use it. So I want to encourage us, let's commit to pursuing our knowledge of each other. And that in actually in that pursuit of knowledge and knowing one another, that we're going to find the incredible treasures, the hidden gems of our relationships. So just to recap from Proverbs 24, from verses 3 and 4, from saying 20, three things, keys to building our homes: wisdom, understanding, and knowledge. And I think if we do this, we're going to build incredible homes, families, relationships that are going to have great strength, great love, great peace, and great joy. Let me pray for you and your families for a moment. God, we thank you for the idea of families, that you've created us to be in relationship with you and with each other. And God, right now, I pray for every family represented, every friendship relationship represented here. God, I pray you'd help us to have wisdom, give us godly wisdom. I pray that you'd speak into situations. God, for anyone right now who's finding themselves at a roadblock, hitting a brick wall in certain relationships, God, would you speak great wisdom? I thank you that when we have wisdom, there is hope to move forward. God, I pray you'd help us to understand each other more, take time to listen to one another, and also that we would be in pursuit of knowledge, that we would learn everything about our families, our relationships, the people in our lives, that we can enrich one another. We can learn how to love each other in a greater way. God, I thank you for everyone here. God, I pray that you would just help them have an incredible day. I pray that you would bless our families in our church, that they would be healthy, strong, you at the center. God, I thank you that our families were born to thrive and flourish. And God, I thank you for every person today, let them have an amazing day. In Jesus' name, amen. Church, love you. Have a fantastic day, and we'll see you real soon.